Hello everyone and very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to another session of PIB 247 where we are going to do some most important questions from the PIB news which are relevant for all the government exams, especially for RBI and NABARD. Alright, so let's begin with the session guys without any delay, but if you want to have your all-round preparation, you can download the MS Excel app from the Google Play Store. And this is the live class to do. Now we are out with a live class course of all the three regulatory bodies examination, that is RBI, SEBI and NABARD. For NABARD and SEBI, the classes are already started. For RBI, the classes will start from 15th of July, right? NABARD mein ARD ki classes, agriculture and rural development ki classes, Suraj sir ne leni start kar di hai. So if you want to have the joy of live classes, then you can enroll in the course. And उसके लिए आपको original.in पे जाना है. Alright, so let's talk about the very first question, guys. Very very important question. I believe ये question किसी ना किसी exam में आपके मिलना चाहिए, whether it is phase one or phase two या interview कहीं पे भी. Right, so consider the following statements with respect to national initiative for promoting upskilling of Nirman workers, and you have to identify the correct statements. Right, so basically this Nirman workers का मतलब यहाँ पे है construction workers. What is the meaning of Nirman workers? By the way, it is construction workers. Construction workers. Now this is for the very first time that the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs has launched anything for upskilling of the construction workers. ठीक है? And this initiative in short is Nipun. Now please don't confuse it with Nipun Bharat program. That is something different. Nipun Bharat is being implemented by Ministry of Education. This is just Nipun, right? So please don't get confused. So let's talk about this Nipun project and then we will come back to the question. So remember, it has been launched by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. Okay, do remember the full form. National Initiative for Promoting Upskilling of Nirman Workers. But the implementing agency, the nodal implementing agency will be National Skill Development Corporation, which is a body under Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. Do you remember this? Right? National Skill Development Corporation will be the implementing agency for this particular initiative or program or scheme, whatever you can call it. Now, the objective of this program, Nipun, is to train over 1 lakh construction worker through fresh skilling and upskilling courses. Unke liye naye skilling or upskilling programs and courses chalaye jayenge, and ye kaun chalayega? There is DC, National Skill Development Corporation. So that is the objective of this project report. And there are 2 industry partners in this as well, which is National Real Estate Development Council and Confederation of Real Estate Developers Association of India, which in short is CREDAI, right? So these 2 are the industry partners. Do you remember this? Now talking more about this program. So remember, the implementation of this project is divided into 3 parts. So its implementation hoga, wo 3 parts mein hoga. Number 1. Recognition of prior learning program ke through training di jayegi. Training will be given through recognition of prior learning at construction site. Now I believe you all know this, recognition of prior learning program is a part of Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana, right? Second, the training will be provided through fresh skilling by plumbing and infrastructure sector skill council. And third, international placement will be done. Theek hai, after skilling and upskilling, international placement bhi ki jayegi, and out of this 1 lakh construction worker jinki upskilling ki jayegi, around 10-12,000 ye target hai, 12,000 ke aas pass jo hai wo foreign placements hoge, right? The courses are aligned with National Skill Qualifications Framework, jo ki of course kaam karta hai under the National Skill Development Corporation, and will be imparted at accredited and affiliated training centers only. Theek hai, recognized training centers jo hai by National Skill Development Corporation, only at these places the training will be provided, right? And it is also envisaged that NSDC will place approximately 12,000 people in foreign countries like Saudi Arabia, UAE and GCC countries. NSDC will provide trainees with Kaushal Bima. Yes, this is very very important. Ek unko insurance bhi diya jayega. They will be provided with a Kaushal Bima, or you can say skill insurance. Kaushal Bima in English is what? Skill insurance, which is a 3-year accidental insurance with a coverage of rupees 2 lakh. 2 lakh rupees ka skill insurance unko diya jayega, jo ki hoga basically accidental coverage, right? एक प्रोजेक्ट कमेटी, और प्रोजेक्ट कमेटी विल बी एस्टैब्लिश्ड, ठीक है, एंड दिस प्रोजेक्ट कमेटी विल कंसिस्ट ऑफ मेंबर्स फ्रॉम एनएसडीसी एंड मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हाउसिंग एंड अर्बन अफेयर्स. टू रिमेंबर दिस, दिस कमेटी विल कंसिस्ट ऑफ मेंबर्स फ्रॉम एनएसडीसी एंड मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हाउसिंग एंड अर्बन अफेयर्स. द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस इंप्लीमेंटेशन विल बी टू ओवरसी एंड मॉनिटर दिस प्रोजेक्ट रिपोर्ट, एंड इट विल बी चेयर्ड बाय एडिशनल सेक्रेटरी कम मिशन डायरेक्टर ऑफ डे एनयूएलएम. नाउ यू मस्ट बी वंडरिंग कि अचानक से डे एनयूएलएम कहां से आके टपक गया. तो रिमेंबर दिस इनिशिएटिव हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड अंडर दीनदयाल अंत्योदय योजना, नेशनल अर्बन लाइवलीहुड मिशन. दैट इज व्हाई जो डे एनयूएलएम के मिशन डायरेक्टर या फिर एडिशनल सेक्रेटरी है, एडिशनल सेक्रेटरी कम मिशन डायरेक्टर है, वही इस कमेटी के चेयरपर्सन होंगे, राइट. तो देयर विल बी अ प्रोजेक्ट कमेटी व्हिच विल हैव द रिस्पांसिबिलिटी टू ओवरसी एंड मॉनिटर दिस प्रोजेक्ट, एंड दैट कमेटी विल बी चेयर्ड बाय एडिशनल सेक्रेटरी कम मिशन डायरेक्टर ऑफ डे एनयूएलएम, राइट. एंड डू रिमेंबर दिस आल्सो दैट दिस स्कीम हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड अंडर डे एनयूएलएम ओनली, राइट. आई होप द प्रोजेक्ट रिपोर्ट इज क्लियर गाइस, एंड नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. इट हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ स्किल डेवलपमेंट एंड एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप. नहीं, is not the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. It is Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, which is headed by Mr. Hardeep Singh Puri. And Hardeep Singh Puri is also the Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas, right? National Skill Development Corporation will be the implementing agency of the project. बिल्कुल सही बात है. This is incorrect. The objective of this program is to train over 1 lakh construction workers. Yes, ये भी अभी हमने पढ़ा. And NAREDCO and CREDAI are the industry partners for implementing this project. So I think सेकेंड थर्ड और फोर्थ स्टेटमेंट के साथ कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. ऑल द थ्री स्टेटमेंट्स 2, 3 एंड 4 आर एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट, व्हिच मींस ऑप्शन या ऑप्शन डी विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर, व्हिच इज ओनली 2, 3 एंड 4. आई होप दैट दिस क्वेश्चन एंड दिस न्यूज इज क्लियर, एंड लेट मी टेल यू इट इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, राइट. लेट्स मूव अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 2. अगेन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन. व्हिच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इंस्टीट्यूट इन द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एजुकेशन हैज बीन अवार्डेड विद द यूनेस्को किंग हमाद बिन इजा अल खलीफा प्राइज. अल खलीफा प्राइज अब हम बोलेंगे इसको क्योंकि बहुत लंबा नाम है. किंग हमाद बिन इजा अल खलीफा प्राइज, राइट, फॉर द यूज ऑफ आईसीटी इन एजुकेशन फॉर द ईयर 2021. नाउ बेसिकली इट इज नथिंग बट अ यूनेस्को रिकॉग्निशन, ठीक है, ये यूनेस्को का रिकॉग्निशन है फॉर यूजिंग ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन एंड कम्युनिकेशन टेक्नोलॉजी इन एजुकेशन सेक्टर, राइट. Let's talk about this news. Remember, UNESCO has recognized the Pradhan Mantri E-Vidya program, which was launched as a part of Atmanirbhar Bharat program. Right, and this PM E-Vidya, इसको इसलिए लॉन्च किया गया था ताकि COVID-19 के दौरान जो स्टूडेंट्स हैं उनकी एजुकेशन के ऊपर कोई इफेक्ट ना आए, राइट. इट वॉज लॉन्च प्रोवाइड यू नो एजुकेशन टू द स्टूडेंट्स, क्योंकि अब ऑफकोर्स स्कूल बंद हो गए थे तो ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन के लिए हमारे पास रिकॉग्नाइज किया गया है, बट दिस अवार्ड जो हमारे क्वेश्चन में एक अवार्ड था वो अवार्ड किसको मिला है. दिस अवार्ड has been given to Central Institute of Education and Technology, and this Central Institute of Education and Technology has taken various steps to implement the PM Vidya program effectively. PM Vidya program effectively implement हो सके इसके लिए Central Institute of Education and Technology ने काफी important steps लिए थे, and that is why this institute CIET has been given this award by UNESCO, right. So Central Institute of Education and Technology has taken various steps in taking learning to the doorsteps of the children through PM E-Vidya program, and that is why it has been awarded with this prize. जो कि हमने क्वेश्चन में पढ़ा, it is हमाद बिन इज़ा अल खलीफा प्राइज फॉर यूज ऑफ आईसीटी इन द एजुकेशन सेक्टर फॉर द ईयर 2021, राइट. Talking about this award, so remember this award recognizes those people who have applied innovative approaches in leveraging new technologies to expand education across the country, okay, across the world in fact, and the award was established in the year 2005 and rewards individuals as well as organizations. Not only individuals are recognized but also organization. If any organization has done a commendable job in this regard, then that organization is also recognized under this award, right. एंड ईच प्राइज विनर रिसीव्स $25,000 मेडल एंड अ डिप्लोमा. तो हमारी तरफ से ऑर्गेनाइजेशन है सेंट्रल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, दैट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन हैज बीन अवार्डेड विद दिस प्राइज, राइट. एंड टॉकिंग अबाउट पीएमई विद्या, सो इट वाज अनाउंस्ड बाय फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर इन मई 2020. इज अ प्रोग्राम दैट प्रोवाइड्स मल्टीमोडल एक्सेस टू डिजिटल एजुकेशन. एज आई टोल्ड यू, इट वाज लॉन्च्ड टू प्रोवाइड एक्सेस टू द डिजिटल एजुकेशन टू द स्टूडेंट्स who are who do not who did not have the access of the digital education that time, right. And under the program many education challenge channels, radio podcast, e-learning content are commencing, jiske andar ye sari cheeze hain. For example, we have Diksha for school education, we have one designated TV channel from class 1 to class 12, youth of radio podcast and community radio, and specially content is also there for specially abled children, right. Now let's come back to the question. You have to identify the name of that organization or institute which has got this award. So it is Central Institute of Education and Technology. Option B is the correct answer to this question. And of course, Minister of Education is headed by Dharmendra Pradhan, who is also the Minister of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. Right? And now let's move ahead to question number 3. Which of the following organizations has won the Prime Minister's Award for Outstanding Contribution towards the Development and Promotion of Yoga 2021? इस पूरे महीने पूरी सरकार सारी मिनिस्ट्री सिर्फ और सिर्फ योगा डे बना रही थी, इसलिए इस महीने बहुत कम न्यूज आई है. मतलब अभी ये तीन दिन ही न्यूज है, 19 to 21 हम पढ़ रहे हैं, एंड ओनली 6 क्वेश्चंस आर देयर जो कि हमारे एग्जाम के लिए या फिर ओवरऑल भी रेलेवेंट है, राइट. तो दिस अवार्ड, अब ये एक और अवार्ड है for promotion, for development and promotion of yoga. It is a Prime Minister's Award. So, kisko diya hai? That is the question. So, remember, the Prime Minister's Award for Outstanding Contribution towards the development and promotion of yoga has been awarded for the year 2021. And of course, these awards are given by for development and promotion of yoga. Yeh iske naam se hi clear hai, right? Now, isme kis kis ko award diya jata hai? Individuals and organizations, dono ko. Individuals and organizations both are awarded. Individuals and organizations. And this year, two individuals and two organizations have been awarded. Now, who are these two individuals? Number one is Sri Bhikkhu Sanghasena from Ladakh and Sri Marcus Vinicius from Brazil. Okay, these are two people. And talking about organizations, so these are Divine Life Society in Rishikesh, Uttarakhand. And then we have British Wheel of Yoga, which is in United Kingdom. और जो awardees हैं उनको cash prize मिलता है कितना? 25 लाख रुपए. Which 25 lakh is given as cash prize to the winners. Right? इससे ज़्यादा detail में जाने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. We have to identify here the name of that organisation which has won this award. So that's Divine Life Society. Option E. Option E, which is located in Rishikesh. Now of course Rishikesh is in Uttarakhand. So let's move ahead to question number 4 now. Consider the following statements with respect to PLI scheme for promoting telecom and networking products, and you have to identify the incorrect statement. Alright, so you must be wondering why we are discussing about this scheme. It was so launched, pehle launch ho chuki hai ye. So why we are discussing about it? We are discussing about it because its tenure has been extended by a period of 1 year. So PLI scheme for promoting telecom and networking product has been extended by 1 year, and that is why it is the news, and that is why we are discussing about it. Alright, now let's talk about this scheme. Of course, the objective, the name saying it, the name of the scheme is telling us the objective only. It is to boost domestic manufacturing in the telecom and networking products in the country. So, our telecom and networking products ki market hai, wahan pe manufacturing ko increase karna. Total out of the scheme is 12,195 crore, 12,195 crore, 12,195 crores. It is effective since 1st of April 2021 and duration, its duration is up to 2025-26. Okay. Moving ahead, eligible companies, total 31 companies hai jinko is scheme ke under incentive diya jayega. Total 31 companies are there. Around 31 companies, 16 are MSMEs and 15 are non-MSMEs. The scheme stipulates a maximum, a minimum investment threshold of rupees 10 crore for MSME and 100 crore for non-MSME. मतलब अगर ये जो 16 MSMEs हैं, these MSMEs have to invest at least 10 crore in order to get the incentive under this particular scheme. If they do not invest rupees 10 crore, they will not get any incentive, right? And similarly for non-MSME, this minimum threshold is rupees 100 crores, right? An incremental production of around 1.82 lakh crore over this scheme period is expected, and the core component is of this scheme is to offset the huge import of telecom equipment, which is approximately 50,000 crore, jo ki lagbhag kitna hai 50,000 crore ka hai. So of course, jab hamari domestic manufacturing increase hogi, to jo hamara import hai wo kam ho jayega. If the domestic manufacturing increases, the import will decrease, right? And this is the incentive support which is being given. For first year, for MSMEs it is 7%, for non-MSMEs it is 6%. Second year again 7%, third year 6%, 5% and 4%. These are for the 5 years. And for others, it is 6%, 5%, 5% and 4%. Right? So that's it about the scheme. I hope this is clear. And now let's come back to the question. You have to identify the incorrect statement. Total outlay of the scheme is rupees 12,195 crores. Total 31 companies have been selected under the scheme. Out of these 31, 16 are MSMEs and 15 are non-MSMEs, right? Core component of this scheme is to offset the huge import of telecom and networking products, which is more than 50,000 crore. So, ye bhi sahi hai, ye bhi sahi hai, ye bhi sahi hai. That is incorrect. Will be the correct answer, option D, right? Moving ahead to question number. Union Health Minister Mansukh Mandavia had participated in G20 Health Ministers meeting. Where was this meeting held? Very easy question, very easy question. G20 ki chari meeting is saal kaha pe ho rahi hai? Indonesia pe ho rahi hai. The correct answer is Indonesia only. Right? And there is nothing that we have to go into the details of this particular news. Bas jaake wahan pe bhashan baaji hui hai aur kuch nahi hua hai. So this G20 Health Ministers meeting was held in Indonesia. Option A is the correct answer. Question for today, where has the National Conference on Cyber Safety and National Security, which is titled as Cyber Apraadh Se Azadi, been organized by Indian Cyber Crime Coordination Center, I4C, right? It was under the Ministry of Home Affairs, headed by Amit Shah. So where was this organized? It was organized at New Delhi. Option A is the correct answer. And again, there is no need to go into the details of this conference that usne kya bola aage. That is not important for us, right? Alright, so that's it for the session today. I hope all the questions and their explanations are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.